Our magnificent planet has truly modest beginnings. Tiny grains of dust, too small to be pulled together by gravity. Somehow, it will have to grow from dust to solid rock. It'll require mysterious forces, cosmic lightning, and luck. Only then can gravity work its violent magic.
A supernova explosion triggers a chain of events that will eventually create the Earth. The formation of our solar system. A hot ball of gas grows in the center. This will become our sun. The dust that swirls around it will form the planets. But first, the grains must stick together.
So we have this interesting conundrum, right? So this disk consists of gas and dust particles. They're about the size of, let's say, particles in smoke, right? Let's say cigarette smoke, right? So these are small things. And somehow we have to get from those little grains to what we see on the Earth.
Gravity is a powerful attractive force. It shapes galaxies and solar systems. But specks of dust are far too small to pull on each other. Somehow, they clump together to form planets. So if gravity doesn't bind them, what does? In Germany, scientists are on the case. They can simulate how dust behaves in space inside a huge tower.
Here we do free fall experiments. So the whole experimental setup, including our dust aggregates, are in perfect free fall. It is simulation of space, but a very good one indeed. I think this is the closest you can get to space on Earth.
Researchers place dust in a container and load it into a launch capsule. At the base of the tower, they lower it into a super powerful catapult. This launches the half-ton capsule from 0 to over 100 miles per hour in a quarter of a second. 400 feet up, the capsule reaches the top of the tower, then plunges back down. A drum of polystyrene balls, 30 feet deep, breaks its fall. All this gives just 10 seconds of zero gravity. Just enough time, they hope, for the dust to stick.
3, 2, 1, and go.
Moments after the capsule launches, the dust inside becomes weightless. The grains clump together, just as in the early solar system. These images reveal how dust particles came together 4.5 billion years ago to form the Earth.
The force that binds the aggregates together is not gravity. They are too small for gravity to be efficient. We think the force that binds the aggregates together is electrostatic force.
Dust particles join to form balls of fluff.
The little static charges that they have can make them stick when they hit. And you get something sort of like the dust bunnies that I have a lot of underneath my bed.
These cosmic dust bunnies are planets in the making. They start out smaller than a pinhead, then grow. The dust is now in clumps, but it's still just balls of dust. Turning dust balls into rocks takes a whole new process. A cosmic electric storm. Space clouds build up charge just like clouds here on Earth. generating huge bolts of lightning.
Balls of dust can turn into solid rocks by an energetic event like lightning.
The electric bolts smash through the dust balls and heat them to 3,000 degrees Fahrenheit. In minutes, they cool and fuse into solid rock. Meteorites today still carry these ancient rock balls inside them. These tiny globules were once the building blocks of planets. To form the Earth, these tiny balls must collide, stick, and grow. The baby Earth is now the size of a few city blocks, big enough for a new force to take charge, gravity.
Once gravity starts to rear its head, things really speed up, because instead of just randomly plowing through material and getting bigger that way, now it's starting to draw material in.
Gravity pulls rocks together, then holds them there to produce bigger and bigger piles of rubble.
So this formation process, which was taking a long time to get to the size where gravity kicks in, suddenly gets kicked into overdrive, and the planet grows very rapidly.
But planets are more than just overgrown rock piles. These rocks are lumpy and inert. How did the Earth become round and full of life?
Our proto-Earth is now just a lopsided lump, one of billions of asteroids, but a demolition derby is about to set it on a course to become a real planet. To do that, it has to become a sphere. The planet building process is magnificently violent and so powerful, it will melt the entire newly formed world.